if you haven't saved your file, this is a good time to save it. Now we're gonna move to our wine or beer bottle, but we will do a wine for this one. You know, when I drew it, I did realize it could be both. I had wine in mind. So you don't have to do it, but you have to create a label. So what we're gonna do, the label, really simple. We will first use our rectangle tool and draw a rectangle. Make sure it's not too high, just wide, kind of like this. Eyeball it. Doesn't have to be perfect size. Don't think where the bottle is gonna be. Doesn't matter. And fill it with white. So the default white, and then edges, the stroke, black. So you can just do the bottom here, fill, black and white, or click D on your keyboard. Okay. Next, what you're gonna do is draw an ellipse or a circle. To make a perfect circle, hold the shift key and then draw it. Kind of make sure it extends above your rectangle and kind of move it in the middle, right? Make sure it's in the middle. So you can move it to make it fit. Then, well, guess what we're gonna use? The Pathfinder option. And it's gonna be the Unite. So when you select both shapes, select both of them, go under Window Pathfinder, and the first one under your shape mode is Unite. So unite that shape, so you kind of have like a label. Okay, now we'll be using our type tool, and a few things we're gonna do. First, we will do the date. That's gonna be 2014 for today. Now this is a pretty big type, and you can use, I'm using the stencil one. Go ahead and use the stencil for the year. Maybe not, it's not too fancy. So let's use something else. Yes, use Lucida. Lucida Grande. Regular. Okay? And make the size 12 points. Actually, that's still too big. 10 points. So I have Lucida Grande. Regular. I called her Lucinda before. Right. Under your type. Right. Next, we're going to be typing our name, Creative Vineyards. If it doesn't fit, it'll be two lines. Actually, this class, I didn't make it fit. We can make it. Yeah, so creative. Now, if you think it doesn't fit in one line, we can put it in a separate line, okay? It's up to you, depending how you draw your label.
Same font?
We actually will change the font in a minute. I just want to type it first. Because I want to see the size. I'm just going to select my selection key after I type it. And we will change it to Lucida Calligraphy Italic. Okay, calligraphy. You'll see that calligraphy. Now you probably see that we need to change, maybe make it all centered. So change your paragraph next to your character if you don't see it. If the command is command T. If you don't see your character, command T is the way to go. Paragraph, center, then you can just move it. And we also want to bring it closer, so change the leading to 10 points. Okay, so we're looking at those measurements. Okay, so once I did it, now we're going to put the bottom part of the text, which is the name of the wine, and we will put Merlot. Oh, don't click inside the shape, because that's what's going to happen. Click outside here and type Merlot. And my type is pretty big. I think I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller by making it 9 points. And now we can add some color to it. So select like a deeper red shade for the Merlot, the name for the fill. Okay, so we're kind of looking like, this is our label. I'm trying to center everything now. So you can go ahead and center it if you feel like it needs it. If you feel your text needs to be expanded, you can go ahead and use the tracking on it. So you can manipulate the text how you want to. I actually will expand my type. A little bit. So I expanded my type. I just made it wider. Okay? So at this point you have this. Now what I've noticed now when I'm looking at it, I feel like my shape is kind of too condensed. I will spread it out a little bit. I'm not want to change the type. I just want to change my shape. Right? Because I want to add some decorative elements to it. So I will kind of make it a little bit bigger here. Move it around. Now we can actually add some decorative element in the bottom here. We can select your type tool, okay? And before you actually do anything, select, there's a type, it's right above Verdana, and it's the decorative type. Let me find Verdana first. It's this one, you see that? It doesn't have a name here. So right above Verdana, the V, right, is this type. So you can use any letter you want to kind of add decoration. So this is decorative type. And I'm just going to type F. It's going to give me two leaves. And you can use other ones if you find better, work better. Okay. And I will adjust. I think I'm going to make a little bit smaller size. This. Right, so there is my vineyard, my label done. So I will, so we can actually apply our work to our 3D object, but we have to make it into a symbol. So the easiest thing would be selecting all that, what we have done, going to our symbols, and once you selected everything, you can just do new. Instead of dragging it, I would just do new symbol, and then go ahead and name the label. And then okay. So I'm gonna, at this point we don't need that label, so we can delete it. So once you have in your symbols, delete it, okay? And at this point, save your document, because sometimes with 3D revolving, things crash. So save, let it spin for a minute. Now select that bottle stroke, the half bottle. So select that, then go into your effects 3D and select revolve. So basically it's gonna look at one shape and kind of revolve around it. That's what it's doing. And do preview. See, nice, right? It's cool. So it's doing the bottle. Actually that does look better like a beer bottle. I'm sorry? Just so go ahead and select that. Now what we're gonna leave alone are the settings here, they're fine, but you notice few things. One of the things you see is more options, so click on more options, and you can see actually when you click on it, make sure you still can see your bottle, okay? And now what this will do, the more options, it actually works with the shading, with your light and the intensity of the light. Right now we only have one light source, so you look in the thumbnail, you only see one. What we're gonna do is add another one. So there's new button right below it, it says new light, click on that. So you notice now it's more light on it. Now the way I want you to move it is a little bit towards the bottom right. That's too much. Maybe I'm moving. I will change my mind in a minute. I'm trying to see what looks best. Okay, let's move it right somewhere around the middle. Kind of doesn't go even. So kind of like this, something like this. Now the light is really intense right now. Now those options on the side, the light intensity only applies to those light sources individually. Everything else applies to the whole light. That makes sense? So what we're going to do is change the intensity for both light that we created to something less, and then let's see what's better. Okay, I'm going to make it 75 is fine. So I'm doing the bottom light at 75 intensity. And then my top one, let me see if I want to reduce it or not. I kind of gonna like it 100%. What do you think? Do you want to reduce it? Yeah, we're gonna leave it alone. Now, what we're gonna change is we're gonna look at the ambient light. This is just the light that illuminates from the top, kind of goes around. And you can see, I just look at what it will do if we move it. So it makes everything else lighter. You see the bottom becomes lighter. So go ahead and move that to 60. You can type it in. If not, you can use your arrow keys or your middle of the mouse for the measurements, the top point. Now, intensity of the light, highlight, is for any of the highlights. You can actually adjust it. You can make it more intense. You see the highlight becomes more intense, right? Or you can make it less intense. So what we're going to do, we probably will put it around 45. That looks like good. So make it 45. Kind of not the most intense light, but still shows. So change the light intensity to 45. Next is the highlight size. Now with highlight size, you can go very low and you don't see any highlight, or you can go high. Okay, so I think we're good as a default. So we leave it as default. Okay, the blend steps. Now this is what can get you into freezing and doing weird things. This is just how smooth the blend will be. So the more steps it has, the smoother it is, but at the same time, it will take time to process. So you notice if I do fewer steps, and you can do it too, it's not going to be as smooth, okay? But let us go ahead and just bump it up to 40, okay? So just do 40 steps and you see how much smoother the blend will appear. All right, so that's where we want to do those measurements, and it helps to make your own kind of light source. Next, what we're going to do, we're going to add the symbol to it. So the way you do it, you will click on map art. One thing I want to mention about map art, and to me, it seems like the symbol on surface should be switched, because you really want to first find the surface and then add the symbol. Because if you just select the symbol now, it will add your surface to whatever is selecting on your shape. You notice right now here, it's selecting the top of my bottle. Well, if I do that, my label that I created, my symbol, will be applied to it. So to me, those two should be changed. That makes more logical sense. So what you have to do is you have to find the surface first. So we're going to do this bottle. Right, so let us go. You lose the arrow keys. Okay, so let's see. Looks like 5 may work, but wait, let me do it first. I'm gonna do symbol, and let me do the label. It's not showing. If it's not showing, that means that 5 is probably behind. And that's how you can tell. Now, what you have to do is delete it. Now, delete doesn't work here, so you actually have to do none. Right? That's why I said this should be separated. So we have to continue again until we have the front showing. So for me, it's 10. So 10 works for me, should be the same for you. So surface 10. If somebody closed it, you can go into, if you box and close it, you can go into appearance and then bring it up. Okay, so surface 10. So I'm going to label for the 10. And now I can move it somewhere on top of my bottle. So kind of move it around. Now, one thing I want you to see though, before you ask for help and you miss something. Notice that my label is a different shade. The light is not shown on the label because you need to select shade artwork. That way it's going to give you the shading applied to the bottle, apply to your label. If you don't check that, it will be just plastic. So make sure you check shade artwork to label, then okay. And when you're done, you just click okay, and then you save your file. Click okay, save it, and you can submit the file to my Dropbox, and you're free to enjoy the rest of your evening. Have fun.